There is a lot to know about regression. And this is simple linear regression. It gets more complicated from here. So let's make sure that you understand how to interpret the output of the regression. This will be a review of some things that we have already learned. This is the same output as the last video, a simple linear regression about job satisfaction and burnout. I will ask you some questions about the output. Feel free to stop the video, review the output, and see if you can find the answers. If not, I will give you the answer, and then you can look it up in the output. Let's start with the correlation. What is the value of the correlation? Stop the video if you want to and find this value in the output. I'll give you a few moments, and then I'll tell you the answer. The correlation is R equals a positive 0.65. Remember, you would not write the correlation as 0.65 because the R value cannot be greater than 1. Is the regression model ANOVA significant? Yes, it is. Write up the regression model ANOVA in APA style using R, the F value, and P. Your answer should look like this. R equals 0.65, comma, F with 1 and 198 degrees of freedom equals 144.94, comma, P less than 0.001. What is the value of the coefficient of determination, the R squared? R squared equals 0.423. Here we should use the R squared, not the adjusted R squared. What does the R squared value tell you about job satisfaction? The R squared tells you that 42.3% of the variability in job satisfaction is due to burnout. What is the value of A? 235.46. What is the value for B? -2.11. Which of the predictions that we did was most speculative, the least valid? Any guesses? Now, in order to answer this, we should look to the next slide and examine the scatter plot. This is the scatter plot for burnout predicting job satisfaction. We are trying to predict the X values of 25, 50, 70, and 120. But look at the range of data on the X axis. What are the minimum and maximum values? It ranges from 30 to 80, but the data themselves go to about 72. So, which of those predictions was most speculative? The most speculative prediction was 120. But why? Because 120 was predicting outside of the range. We are trying to predict a value that is not within the original data. In fact, the burnout test did not even go up to 120. The predicted job satisfaction was a -17.74. What does that even mean? It's one thing to have a low job satisfaction score, but a negative job satisfaction score? So predicting outside of the range of the data is pointless. And now we have a better idea of why.